Good morning, students. In our previous video, we have started our chapter 3, the discussion part, and we have studied about definition of force. Next, we have studied about the effects of force. Then, we have studied about type of force, that was contact and non-contact force, unit of force. Then, in contact force, we have studied muscular force and frictional force. In non-contact force, we have studied magnetic force, electrostatic force, and gravitational force. As I have given you the question and answer earlier only, today we will complete this chapter. The discussion portion, we will complete it today. And the topic which we are going to start today, that is frictional force, which is also known as friction. Let us define frictional force. The opposite force, we can define it as the opposite force acting on a body. We can define it the opposite force acting on a body to slow down its motion is called, you can write either friction is called friction, or you can write frictional force. The opposite force acting on a body to slow down its motion is called friction, or you can say it frictional force. Now let us understand by few example. As earlier also we have studied about friction and few examples we have discussed, today also for making it more clear, let us discuss one example. You all have watched cricket, or you all are watching cricket whenever it is being displayed in TV channel, then you might have seen that when a batsman strikes a ball, when he hits a grounded shot, the ball moves, rolls over the ground. The ball rolls over the ground, and as the ball covers the distance, you can see that the speed of ball slowly slows down, and at the last it is stopped. So there is some force which is acting opposite on that ball to stop it. That type of force is called frictional force. Or you can take one more example, cycling. Suppose you are cycling, you are riding a cycle, and when you stop pedaling it, when you stop pedaling the bicycle, slowly it stops. That means that an opposite force is acting on your body to stop the cycle. That opposite force is known as frictional force. So many examples are there for the frictional force which we are using in real life. Example, due to friction only we are able to walk. If friction is not there in the environment, we will be unable to walk. Now let us see the next topic, factors affecting friction. What are the factors which affect friction? It means what are the factors in which friction is more, and what are the fraction in which friction is less. There are two points or two factors you can say. First is nature of two surface. Since it is a contact force, it means both the surface should be in contact with each other. Nature of two surface, either both the surface will be smooth or both the surface will be rough. This is the first point, first factor. Second is force applied. How much force is being applied? These are the two factors in which friction depends. Like the very first we will discuss about nature of two surface. As you can see in your book, in page number given in page number 53, one example is given. Let me show you that example. This example is given. Here two body A and B are in contact each other, and you can see that the surface in which they are in contact, that surface is quite rough. Is it possible to move this A over B? It will be quite difficult, because due to the rough surface, the frictional force between these two objects is too much. That's why it will be difficult to slide this object A over B due to the rough surface. Now, if the surface is smooth, then it will easily move the object. One more example let us see in this book. Here you can see that the surface of floor is smooth. One object TMT, that is brick, is kept, and it is being pulled by tying a rope, and here it will be easier to move the brick over the smooth surface. One more example you can see here the same type of figure is given. Here one object is light box, here heavy box, in which you can see both the surfaces are smooth. It means it will be easier to move this box on this surface. Now let us move to our second point, that was force applied. How much force is being applied? Now in this example we will understand how much force is being applied. Now in case of light box, as the surface of both the object is smooth, it means it will be easier to move, or it will be easier to slide these object. But if the object is light, it will be too much easier to slide this object over the surfaces. But if the object is heavy, it will be difficult. So there are two factors which we have studied: nature of two surface. If it is smooth, then easier to roll or easier to move through the surface. It means when it is smooth, the friction will be less, and when it is rough, friction will be more. Here I will write here, if it is smooth, friction will be less, if it is rough, friction will be more. Now force applied. If object is heavy, again two condition is here. If object is heavy, if object is light. If object is heavy, friction will be more. If object is light, friction will be less due to the force. Now let us move to our next topic, that is type of friction. Hope that with these examples and concept there should be some doubt, but almost it is clear to you all that what is friction. We have to understand only the opposite force working on a body to slow down the motion of an object is called the frictional force. Now coming to the type of friction, there are three type of friction. First is static friction, second is sliding friction, and the third is rolling friction. These are the three type of friction which we are going to study one by one. Let us start static friction. The first type of friction is static friction. By the definition, static friction says that maximum force present between two objects when one object just tend to move or slip. When one object just tends to move or slip over the surface of another object. It's called static friction. If two objects are there, and one object is the surface and another object which is kept over it, and if that object moves or slip over the surface, that type of friction where the friction will appear, and that type of friction is called static friction. You can see the example given in the book in page number 56. The same example, these two surface, this is the surface, smooth surface, and this is the object. Now it will either slip over the surface or it will either slide over the surface. You can say that move over the surface. This type of friction will be called as static friction.
Now next is sliding friction. Sliding friction means when an object slides over other object. Slide means fisalna. Sliding friction. When an object moves slowly or slides over other object is called sliding friction. By the name you all know that sliding means fisalna. When an object slides slowly over other object, when it is sliding slowly, that type of friction, the friction which will produced, that type of friction will be called as sliding friction. The third type of friction is rolling friction. Rolling means to roll. When an object rolls over other object, then that object is called, friction is called rolling friction. When an object rolls over another object, that type of friction is called rolling friction. You can see in the given example in your book. Here you can see book is kept on a surface of table. Now here it is sliding friction. Now if some pencils are kept below that book, now it will start rolling because pencil will provide wheel. Here the friction will generate, that type of friction is called rolling friction. Like example, you can see that trolley bag. In trolley bag, wheels are fixed at the bottom, and in which the wheels are rolled over the surface or rolled over the ground, the friction which present there, that type of friction is called rolling friction. Hope that all these three type of friction is clear to you. Now the rolling friction is much more less. If the friction will be less, the object will move on the surface very easily. If the friction is more, the object will be face difficulty in moving. Now let us move to our next topic. Our next topic is advantage of friction. Now what are the advantages? Because as we have studied now, friction is very much useful for us in our daily day-to-day life. Now we will study what are the advantages. First advantage is friction enable us to walk without slipping. Friction is the force which help us to walk without slipping. Now due to this friction we are able to walk without slipping. As you have seen, if the banana, if the that waste part of that banana which we are throwing, if our legs is kept on that banana, we used to slip over the ground. Or if a surface is oily, if oil is distributed in the surface, we often slips because it reduces the friction. That's why friction enable us to walk without slipping. If friction is there, we can easily walk. If friction is less over the surface, then we cannot walk properly, we will slip. Now because friction plays a vital role in our daily life to walk from one place to another place. Now second advantage is friction enable us to apply brake and slow down or stop a moving car. As we are applying brake, it means we are applying opposite force on the wheel of the car or wheel of the cycle, and it stops the moving vehicle. This is the second. The third advantage is friction enable us to write and draw on paper. Due to the friction, we feel easier to write and draw on the paper. Suppose if I will give you a task to draw on that surface in which oils or some sticky things, some slippery things is kept, you will not be able to draw even a single line properly. That's why friction enable us to draw and write on a paper. Next advantage is friction enable us to pick up and hold thing in our hand. Due to the friction, we can pick anything or and we can hold those things in our hand. If the friction is less, then it will slip from our hand, like powder. When we are playing carom, why do we put powder in carom? To reduce the friction so that it should slip over the surface. Now next advantage is nails can be fixed in wall or wood due to friction. This is the frictional force by the help of which nails are fixed, because whatever force we are applying by this hammer, the same amount of force will be applied by the wall and the nail will be fixed in the wall. These are the advantages of friction which we are facing in our day-to-day life. One more example is there. Friction enable us to light a matchstick. Suppose if friction is not there, if the surface is smooth, this matchstick will easily move through and lighting will be done. That's why friction enable us to light the matchstick also. These were the advantage of friction. Why friction is required? Now there are some disadvantage also. Disadvantage of friction. Now first disadvantage is friction wears away the soles of our shoes. The shoe which we are wearing, shoe or slipper which we are wearing, the soles of those shoes or slipper wear out due to the friction. That is one of the disadvantage. Second disadvantage is in the case of tire, when the tire is moving over the road, after some time or after some months, you can see that the treads, whatever is made on the tire is moved out. Now see, this is the new tire and this is the old tire. After few months or few years, the tire is worn out, or you can say that teared out. These are the disadvantage. Now next disadvantage, friction wear out the rubbing machine part. Friction can damage the machine part also. If friction is more, that's why we used to put oil over the chain of cycle or motorcycle so that friction should be less, so that the machine part should work for a longer time. Friction wears out the brake pad of vehicle gradually. Due to the friction, the braking pad by the help of which the brakes are applied on the vehicle, that wear out due to the friction. Next disadvantage is friction wear out the step of staircase and building and foot of over bridges. Now you might have seen in some places, due to the continuously movement of the people or continuously movement, the surface which is wooden or which is any of the surface, that little bit it wears out slowly, that is due to the friction. Friction produces heat. Whatever machine parts, suppose they have two machine parts are running together with each other. Now here it, due to the friction, it will produce heat. That's why in machinery part, we used to reduce the friction. Now next disadvantage is friction reduces the efficiency of machine. Friction, if friction is more, the machine will not work properly. That's why we are using mobile oil or grease to reduce the friction over the machine. Friction slows down the motion. This we have already studied, that whenever we apply brake is a role of friction over the vehicle, and after applying brake, it slows down the motion of the vehicle. Now there are certain methods to increase or decrease friction. Now how we can increase friction? Now we all know how to increase friction. The first way to increasing friction is by making treads. If tread is more, then we will not slip over the ground. If the soles of the shoes is veered out, then slippery case will be there. Now gymnastic apply some course of substance on their hand to increase friction. Now you might have seen kabaddi, in which kabaddi player used to take the sand over their hand, so that slippery part should be removed, so to increase the friction. Machine belt, you might have seen in flour mill that machine belts are being used to increase the friction, so that the wheels should be driven properly. Now next is how to reduce friction. Now there are certain ways to reduce friction by making the surface. This is very much important topic and you have to study this. Making the surface smooth by polishing. If you polish the surface, then friction will be reduced. When the area of contact is reduced like this, here in this trolley wheels are being attached. Now surface which is being touched with the ground surface will be less, and due to the wheel it reduces the friction. Now by using ball bearing, here ball bearing is being used for reducing friction. Now lubricating, it means by providing oil, grease, fine powder, by these applying these things the friction can be reduced. Streamlining means there are all the vehicles, all the boats, all the aeroplane, they are made streamlined so that friction should work less on the object. If friction is more, then the object will be moving slowly over the ground. Suppose we are talking about aeroplane, the structure of aeroplane, why it is like that? Because it is streamlined to cut the friction, so that friction should be less over the surface and the aeroplane can move easily through the air. By this, your first terminal topic is over, chapters are over, and your task is to do revision. And if you will be having any doubt, you can raise the query, and question and answer is given to you earlier only. Now you do your revision work, and if any doubt will be there, you tell me in WhatsApp. I will again make a video for a revision and I will provide you then.